Our next story is called Renee's Ride.
We connect to each other through story.
Now, Renee was a young woman who sat in a wheelchair.
There's just no question that that's how all of us learns and understands about our world.
And Renee was sitting in her wheelchair at the top of a hill, and down at the bottom of the hill, there was a lilac bush. And so what Renee did, she released the brake. Can you release the brake on Renee's wheelchair? You know how to do that.
When somebody who has disabilities is connected through story, they have a better understanding, not only of the lives of other people, but they also have a better understanding of themselves and a better ability to share themselves with the world.
Name,
Gwen, what's your name?
Beth.
Nice to meet you, Sarah.
Technology has brought us tremendous benefits to the profoundly disabled community. Tremendous benefits. We've got beepers and buzzers and computer programs and everything else that really makes life easier, and things that lift and support and move people's bodies. Machines that do that. This isn't about machines.
Right.
This is about human connection, person to person, hand over hand, eye to eye contact, voice, touch. Let's do this together. It can be safe if you do it with me. Experiences.
Can? The trash can fell to the ground. This story should be exciting. Stories should have some pieces that make us uncomfortable. That's what all good stories have. Bringing people safely through that to the place where when you bring them back at the end of the story, everything's okay. That's the gift of storytelling.
You want to fill the tree?
So much of their environment and how they interact and how they draw within themselves has to do with their environment. They have sensory integration problems, and when you use the touching stories, you're introducing them to their environment.
What could it be?
These are for people for whom access to the story only happens when there's a rich and multiple senses are presented with a very simple story.
The room was covered in darkness and she couldn't see anything.
Touching Stories is funded primarily at this point through private donations.
Smell the cookies she was baking.
But if we want to grow, we're going to have to find other ways to fund this project, because right now we have this very nice little program that reaches about 3 to 4 different day programs a year. We want everybody to have access to this. We need people to spread the word about our program. We need people to talk about what we're doing, and we need people to help us reach our goals by donating to our program.